the thing that I've put a large part of my time into at CADA has been the CADA Metrics Working Group. This is a group which is trying to push the idea that measurements are important and to get more people interested and involved in doing them, and to look at some of the interesting problems that that turns up. It's an open working group, but it's a small working group which is fairly tightly focused on trying to produce useful results in a fairly short time. We have two co-chairs from industry, Sue Moon from Sprint Labs, Brett Watson from AboveNet. So what I'm going to cover this morning is the metrics working group and what it's all about. The measurement FAQ, which is a document that the group has produced, which we'd really like some feedback on. I'm going to have a quick look at some common metrics and how they're defined. Then I'm going to enter the availability rat hole. That is, everybody talks about it, but nobody really cares too much about what it means. So we're going to try a definition on you and seek some feedback. The metrics working group has two main goals. One is education. So we've produced an FAQ, which is a background document, which has a lot of material relating to measurement, which is collected together for people who are interested. And I'll go through that in a little more detail in a moment. And the main part of the working group's activities are to work through and define metrics, particularly metrics for new and emerging services. We haven't actually set any bounds as to what they might be, but quality of service is one sort of obvious area, if only we could all agree on what that means. But the outcome from all of this should be a service measurement toolkit, that is, a list of things which we think people really should be measuring and recommended good ways to do it. And given that we can come up with such a thing, then we'd like to encourage people to implement that and to generally coordinate that sort of activity. And the third goal is to produce a revised version of the CADA's document on measurement requirements for hardware and software vendors. This has been around for at least 2 years. It's pitched at customers, that is the people who buy networking hardware, and it's been, as it stands at the moment, on the CADA website. It's aimed at some users, but there's been very little response from the user community, so we encourage you to read that and give us some feedback on that. Now, what's in the FAQ? Well, it's aimed at users, that is, corporate users who are trying to run their networks, who are dealing with providers, that's you guys, so that they will understand how services should be defined, what kinds of things they're asking for. It goes through... also, I need to point out, this slide, there's 20 minutes worth just in this slide, so we're really just going to go quickly through the headings. That'll be true for the next slide as well. There are a lot of sections covering generally accepted terms, so that we all use the same vocabulary, we all know what we're talking about. There's a lot of discussion on different measurement topics, active versus passive, when is it better to use one or the other, what are the advantages, one point versus many, how do you get on measuring inside a network as compared to out at the edges, which is better, are there advantages one way or the other, what should you be doing on your particular network. Issues about sampling, and that's a big area where there's not very much published and not a lot of good understanding. That's something which is not going to go away. We all need to try a bit harder on that one. And on the statistics front, again, there's a lot of fog about. Statistics are something which, in principle, are very simple, but they're not well understood. So there's a lot of background on that. The rest of the material in the FAQ goes into a fairly detailed description of the common metrics. These are the ones which everybody should be measuring. Latency, packet loss, throughput, utilization, and availability. I mention availability there because, as you'll see in a moment, it keeps coming up in service specifications and things like that. Then there's a section on common measurement tools, which is a sort of super condensed version of the CADA tools taxonomy page, just going through the tools for measuring the common metrics. And the last thing, which I'll tell you about now, there's a fairly long section which provides some ideas which you can use, well, which customers can use to compare service offerings from different providers. So now we come to the interesting part, talking about how do we specify network service. Now, there's quite a few providers, big providers and small providers, who publish service level agreements on the web. And I've listed a few of those. And these describe the services which they're offering to customers. At this point, SLAs are a sort of hot potato, and people have been trying to push me away from talking about them. So I'm not going to talk about service level agreements, I'm talking about service specifications. That is to say, I'm not interested in the contractual part of service level agreements. What happens if the service level isn't met, that kind of stuff. I'm only interested in trying to specify exactly what services should be. And from your point of view, that's what you should be interested in too. And the first sort of really obvious thing about this, as you read the service definitions on the web, is that the metrics which they use to define the services are often poorly defined. Words like latency and availability, again, are used, and nobody really says exactly, well, not nobody, but very often people don't say what they mean. So to illustrate this, we'll look at a typical example, and I picked this one because it was a good example, concisely put, easy to understand. These are from UUNET's SLA page. UUNET says that for network quality, they provide an average monthly latency of no more than 85 milliseconds for a round trip within UUNET's network in America, no more than 120 milliseconds between New York and London. All of which is fine. They've taken the trouble to make it clear that they are only promising things within their own network. They don't particularly define latency, and they don't really tell you what they mean by average monthly latency. So they don't tell you things like how often do they test the latency, how do they do that test, things like that. And one of the things which is a bit surprising is that they say nothing at all about packet loss. And some of the other people who put service level specifications on the web do say things about packet loss. Going on from there, the second part of the UUNET service spec talks about service quality. And they say that their service provides 100% availability over the UUNET backbone and that part of it that connects to you. But they also say that we do this stuff called scheduled maintenance, and that takes place every now and then, but they don't tell you whether or not the scheduled maintenance time is included in the 100% availability. So that's a bit of a puzzle, and it leaves wide open the question, you know, what do they really mean by availability? The next angle on this whole thing is, given that you've managed to specify the service that you're offering, how are you going to measure it, and how are your customers going to know that they're getting what they're paying for? Well, one of the things which a lot of providers do is to publish pages on the web giving status reports on how their network is doing. Sean Donnellan ran an email thread on the NANOG list for quite some time, and that produced a list of about 13 different providers who publish status pages. And in the FAQ, those are all listed with their URLs. When we look at those pages, the amount of detail which they give varies a lot. Some of them are simple network status pages. They tell you about the current outages, they tell you about the current problems. Others give you quite detailed statistics about what's happening. They give you matrices showing what the transit times are from point to point within the network. Some of them just give you a monthly percentage, which it's the same sort of information but compressed into one or two numbers. So it's very interesting to look at the different provider status pages. And again, there's a list of half a dozen URLs for those in the measurement FAQ. But you know, that's all very well in terms of being publicity about how good your network is, but it doesn't say very much to your customer about what sort of performance the customer expects from their connection through your network. So for that, customers really need to make their own measurements. And I'll come back a little later on and give you an example of the kinds of things which can be done. Moving on from there, looking at common metrics, well, throughput and utilization, lots of people do that. That's pretty straightforward. You can't buy a box these days that doesn't have an HTTP agent in it, and there are tools like MRTG so that you can collect current throughput from the different interfaces and plot them nicely with MRTG. When it comes to latency, as it's used in the service specifications, that usually means round trip time, and most people just measure it with ping, which of course gives you packet loss measurements as well. When it comes to availability, there really isn't a definition. So the working group has come up with one, which I'm about to try on you, and I'll just remind you this is an attempt to define it, and we really need some feedback. So we say there is no such thing as a single availability measurement. As a customer, what you have to do is to think about what it is you're wanting. What is it that's important to you? So we define three levels of availability. Network availability, which means you can send packets to the internet from your place and get some sort of response. Host availability means that you can get the packets to some particular host which is important to you and, again, get proper responses. And service availability means being able to send the packets for some particular service and get the right response. So as a customer, when you're thinking about what you want, you need to say, well, I need to be able to get a response within such and such a time for pages from such a web server or something like that. For measuring it, there's not very much to add to that. Starting from the top going down, if all is well, of course, you're probably not too worried about that. But if you want to know how it's going, then you need it, and it's a web server, then you need to download test pages from time to time and measure how long it takes to get that back. If you lose service availability, then you probably, the next thing you do is to test to see whether the host is available, and you do that by pinging the target host, which verifies that you have connectivity to it and it'll respond to ICMP. And if that fails, then the question is, well, do you have network availability? So you can run traceroute and see how far into the network your packets get. So that's the basic idea. When it comes to doing this, what the FAQ suggests is that as a customer, you need to sit down with your provider and work through what the service is really going to be and what both sides mean by availability. So you have to decide between you what services are important and what sort of performance level in terms of latency and packet loss and so forth is acceptable. I've thrown in be realistic. We can't promise more than we can deliver. Although there's one point which is worth making there. Some packet loss is inevitable. TCP, after all, relies on packet loss to detect congestion. So it's quite unrealistic for a customer to suggest that they might want 0% packet loss. Given that both sides are working together properly on this, then both sides need to figure out what kind of measurements they're going to make to verify that it's really working. And they need to make some measurements early on while everything's working properly to use as a baseline for later on. So I have an example of the kind of measurements which you can make. Here's a plot which I managed to produce last Friday. This is totally passive measurements, looking at all of the traffic coming and going through the commercial commodity internet gateway at San Diego Supercomputer Center. So it's all of the traffic from UCSD into the internet. And out of that, I've picked traffic that comes and goes to and from a couple of the root name servers. So the top plot, the red one, is, is the response from the A root server, which you can see when it's going well is down around 100 milliseconds to get a response back, but it fluctuates up to about 200 milliseconds. And you can see the gap a wee bit to the left of the middle there, where service disappeared completely for about 3 hours. I think we had a definite loss of network availability at that point. And you can see that there are peaks occasionally, blips on the green line, which is the S root server, where for some reason the server response dropped away. The bottom trace is the percentage packet loss, and you can see that that has interesting daily patterns. There's about 6 days total plot there. And one of the interesting things is that the DNS response time doesn't seem to correlate particularly well with the loss percentage. So this is interesting stuff. There's lots of things to be explained. It's a very early measurement from the natural meter. So, to wind up, the metrics working group has got started. As a fairly small group, we've produced the measurement FAQ, providing background material on a lot of measurement topics, among which we've produced a definition of service availability. We really need some feedback from, particularly from providers, who sooner or later should have, if this actually works out, should have customers beating on them saying, this is what we want to do. So we need to try and be sure that what we've got is workable. So, Metrics Working Group has a web page, which is on the CADA website, www.cada.org. Click on Outreach, click on Metrics Working Group. The CADA website has recently been reorganized so that you can get through any part of it in two mouse clicks, give or take a bit. The Metrics Working Group page has the Working Group Charter, the mailing list archives, the current version of the FAQ draft. So if you'd like to be on the mailing list, the instructions are there. As I said, we really would like feedback on the FAQ. A lot of people on the mailing list have contributed to the FAQ, and I've listed the ones who've actually sent me text here. I've edited the material and written the draft, but of course I can't do this on my own. I'm just coordinating the mailing list. Thanks very much to those people particularly. The CADA tools taxonomy is flagged at the bottom there. That is a good reference site which collects together a lot of information about measurement tools. That's well worth a look too. And the last slide is a summary of some URLs for some of the network performance pages, plus a comment that the ones talking about service definitions and performance reports, they are listed among the references in the FAQ. I think I've succeeded in doing that in very close to 20 minutes. I don't know whether or not we have time for any questions. Okay. Stunned silence. So everybody is quite sure that their network is available.
Thanks, Michael.
Okay.